Hi, my name is Kurt Salu. I'm the president of Global Energy Innovations. Today, I'm going to give you a brief overview with Dr. John McCarty, our chief scientist, of the technology inside the EC2000, which we call CELScan, chemical electrical layer scan.
Hi, I'm Dr. John McCarty, chief electrochemist for Global Energy Innovations. And I'd like to tell you a little bit about the company and how we came to develop the EC series analyzers.
What we've done at Global Energy Innovations is taken a lab grade frequency response analyzer. This one's made by Solatron Analytics, and we've miniaturized it and put it into the palm of your hand. Additionally, we've put a single board computer on board our EC2000 so that we can do signal processing and we can do fast Fourier transforms for noise rejection.
One of the big barriers to moving out of the lab and into an industrial environment is the ambient electrical noise that you have to contend with. It really took a combination of very skillful electronics and mathematical algorithms to extract the signals. But we have done it with such success that we can now measure microvolt changes in the voltage signal.
And our device is a true multi-frequency analyzer that has the same accuracy and repeatability as a benchtop analyzer. One of the key features of our EC2000 is that we have an auto baselining function that automatically baselines a battery in either a good known state or in an unhealthy state in a string. That's unlike any other analyzer in the market. So you can go in and start testing a string of batteries and it'll automatically converge on a baseline so that you can understand the health and the failure modes in the batteries that you're testing.
By the time I got to graduate school in the 60s, the equipment was still only useful really for research activities. It was large and expensive, and it took considerable expertise to interpret the results. 3 decades later, I found myself working at Hughes Space and Communications Company on batteries for satellites. We got together a team, and a member of that team was Kurt Salu, who went on to found Global Energy Innovations. Kurt and I and the other members of the team were asked to do some accelerated tests to see if we could predict the long-term performance of lithium-ion technology. The most effective tool that we had for that turned out to be frequency response analysis. By applying it to the batteries as they were aging, we were able to detect very subtle changes inside the batteries. The end result of all this work is a handheld device which can generate the different frequencies, apply them to the battery, extract the response signal, analyze it, interpret it, and store it all at the push of one button.